Hey there, happy morning, junior kids. Once again, I welcome you all in yet another new day. Let's see today's day's date and day. Today is 12th of November. 12th of November and it's Thursday today. We have reached Thursday. Let's see. So, this is our ABS class. And in ABS class, we were learning about manners. Good manners. Where we have to follow good manners. We have learned that how we have to behave when we go to a restaurant. Okay, so how we have to behave? If we eat the food, we should close our mouth and chew the food. We should not speak loudly in the restaurant. Okay, we should not jump. We should not, walk here and there. If someone is serving you with food, then you have to say thank you. And you have to wait for everyone to be served. And after that, we have seen some good manners that has to be followed at home. Then we have seen some good manners that has to be followed in the bathroom also. Today, we are going to see the good manners in the classroom. Although we are not coming to school, but it's very important to learn the good manners that has to be followed in the classroom. But before that, I'm gonna ask you a question. Can you tell me some behavior that get you into trouble in home? What are the behavior of yours that may get you into trouble? Sometimes hitting your siblings may get you in trouble. Okay, taking the kids without your parents' permission may get you in the trouble. After playing, not putting the toys away when asked may get you in trouble. Okay, and next, being untruthful. Whatever mama says, you're not following, that is being untruthful. Okay, and next, not listening to parents, whatever they are saying to you. So these are some behaviors that may get you in trouble in the home. And what are the consequences? What does mama do when you are not doing, when you misbehave in the house? Mama will obviously shout at you. Okay, and your TV time, your play time will be taken from you. You will be made to sit in a special chair, that is punishment chair. You'll be sit into that special chair. Okay, and next, what else? So your all play time will be taken from you. You will not given permission to go out and play. You will not allowed to watch the TV. Our mama will shout at you. Okay, so this will happen if you misbehave in the home. But what are the behaviors in the classroom that will get you in trouble? What else you do? What are the naughty things? What are the misbehaviors you do in the classroom? Sometimes what do? You hit your friend or you will poke your friend with a sharp pencil, isn't it? You will do this while playing. Okay, not sharing toys with your friend. Okay, pushing your friend. And after that, climbing on the bench in the classes. And running in the stairs and corridors, always running. Leaving out, going out of the class without teacher's permission. All these are the things that put you in trouble in the classroom. What else do we say? Sometimes what do? You snatch toys or some things from your friend, isn't it? Snatching the things, toys from your friend, always shouting in the class or screaming in the class loudly, keeping toys for yourselves only, not giving to your friend, always scratching your hair and picking your nose with the fingers and teasing others. That's the thing that happens in the class, isn't it, children? So what do you think, what will be the consequences of this misbehavior in the class? What does the teacher do or auntie do with you? You won't get chance to play with your friends, isn't it? Teacher will not allow to play you with your friends. And after that, teacher will make you sit in the corner or in a special chair. That is a punishment chair. You will not allow to play your favorite games in the school. Okay, so these are the consequences that will happen if you will not follow or you will misbehave in the class. So what are the good manners you have to follow in the class? The very first is you have to use polite words while talking with your friends. Can you please share your toys? Can you please give me that water? Like this, you have to use the polite words while talking. Please, sorry, excuse me. Like this, you have to use all these golden words. The second thing is, you have to share your things, your toys, everything with your friend. Okay. The third thing is, you should not hurt anyone in the class. Either if you are in the class or if you are in the home. You should not hurt anyone. You should not poke anyone with a pointed object. Okay. And next, you should not litter in the class. Litter means throwing waste papers, making the class dirty. Not in class, also in house also. You should not litter everywhere, wherever you look, wherever you sit, whatever you do. Okay. And next, after doing anything, either whether it is a drawing work or it is a writing work or it is a playtime, you need to clean up the place. Okay, you have to put back the toys where from where you have taken it out. You have to keep your books and color pencils or crayons, everything in your bag after finishing all your work. This is very, very important. Okay, and next, while you eat the snacks, you should close your mouth and chew polite words. And after that, what else you will follow? You should not scream unnecessarily. You should not shout unnecessarily. You should not run. You should not jump. You have to stay in a place. You have to follow all the directions that is being given by you, given to you by your auntie. Or if you are in home, you have to follow the directions that has been given to you by your parent. Okay, children? So these are the good manners that you have to follow in the class. And if you want to go outside you without your parents' permission or your teacher's permission, you should not go out of your house or from the school. It's very important that you should inform your parent or your teacher wherever you're going, whatever you're doing. Okay. So these are some of the good manners that you have to follow. If we would be in the school, we will be following all these things. But unfortunately, due to this COVID, we are at home. And no matter if you are at home, you can follow all these manners, good activities, good behavior in your house also. And parent, I request you all to please do appreciate your children whenever they are following any one of the good manner. Okay. And you can take the video of it also and send it in the group. Okay, children, so do follow all the good manners in all the time, whatever you're doing. Okay, until I meet you in the next class, it's your auntie saying bye and thank you.